Toral, you make some crucial points about what is happening with India and the bottoming out not yet of the industrial sector. I'll just get to that. But the more important point, the fact that US is recovering and the pace of recovery is quite robust. If you mentioned some of the sales data that have also been seen. So the big question then is, will the global liquidity tap shut out, Toral? A lot of the recovery seen in emerging markets, a lot of the markets that have seen the rally in 2012 were primarily due to the sort of the non-stop inflow of the dollar funds across the world. With US recovering, the QE tap is bound to shut off from the Fed. What kind of an impact will that have on emerging markets going ahead, do you think?
Yeah, well, the last Fed minutes did indicate that, you know, some members of the Fed are of the view that the bond buyback program should end middle of the year. It seems unlikely in the current scenario, and I don't think that is a base case scenario. I think interest rates are going to remain low through the world, at least for this year. We probably might see some reversals happening in the next calendar year, but 2013 doesn't seem to be the time when you are going to see global tap shutdown. In fact, Japan just announced a fresh set of stimulus, and the liquidity is going to be there in markets, whether it comes from the US or it comes from certain parts of Asia. For us, clearly, we don't have too much leeway, whether it's fiscal or monetary, and therefore, I expect limited local stimulus. In fact, I would rather have a stringent budget where there is some indication on a move towards the fiscal consolidation, which is what will help markets more than stimulus. On the monetary side also, while we are expecting 50 basis rate cuts this year, I do not expect more rate cuts, and all this is going to be front-ended because inflation, given the way the CPI data is coming out, is likely to start rising again in the second half of the year. So I think certain estimates of maybe 100 plus kind of rate cuts seem to be a little too positive. My sense would be that you get probably a 25 basis cut in the upcoming policy and then maybe another 25 for the rest of the year. And unlikely that you will get more monetary stimulus in the later part of the year. But there you clearly need to watch how the inflation trajectory is moving.
Do you think the euphoria on the market currently is slightly overdone?
I think we'll end this year with 5.5% growth, probably move on to 6.5-6.6% kind of a growth next year. And probably you will see a couple of earnings upgrades coming through in the later part of the year. We have started this result season on a slightly positive note, especially we're seeing upgrades on the IT pack. And all these are large index stocks, so clearly there is a 0.5% to 1% kind of a upside which is possible on the earnings side on Sensex. We still need to get some numbers from PSU banks. Private banks result announced so far have been reasonably good. And on some of the mid-cap numbers that we have got so far are also not very worrying. So my sense is the earnings cycle is bottoming out, and that should be a key driver in the long run for markets to move up. Near term, I would agree that there might be a small correction, having seen huge flows in the last couple of months. In fact, from September onwards, we have almost on a monthly basis had $2 to $3 billion of inflow, and that tap is certainly going to slow down a bit as people come closer to the budget and await what the government does going forward. So policy is going to drive growth, but I think earnings momentum will be key. So if the current policy momentum continues, and with that, if you get some earnings upgrades, I think that is going to be the key driver for the market.